This video is about how to divide hexadecimal numbers.
Hexadecimal is regarded as base 16. The hexadecimal values are 0 to 9 and A to F. A to F represents the values 10 to 15. And the hexadecimal number system is based on the powers of 16.
Now let's try to solve this example. The first step is to convert the divisor, which is 1AF, into decimal. Convert hexadecimal to decimal by multiplying each number by 16. Remember to always start from the right of the hexadecimal number and go to the left when applying the powers of 16. F times 16 to the power of 0 is 15. Then A times 16 to the power of 1 is 160. Then 1 times 16 to the power of 2 is 256. After multiplying one by one, let's add the results to get our decimal equivalent number, which is 431. Since our divisor has 3 digits, let's grab 3 digits on our dividend. So now our first dividend is B36. Let's convert it into decimal by multiplying each number by 16. 6 times 16 to the power of 0 is 6. Then 3 times 16 to the power of 1 is 48. Then B times 16 to the power of 2 is 2816. Let's add the results to get our decimal equivalent number, which is 2870. The next step is to find out how many times 431 goes into our first dividend, which is 2870. Now let's divide 2870 on the decimal value of our hex divisor. So 2870 divided by 431 is 6. Then 6 times 431 is 2586. Because 2586 is in decimal form, let's convert it into hexadecimal. To do that, just divide it by 16. 25 divided by 16 is 1. Then 1 times 16 is 16. 25 minus 16 is 9. Bring down 8. 98 divided by 16 is 6. Then 6 times 16 is 96. 98 minus 96 is 2. Bring down 6. Then 26 divided by 16 is 1. Then 1 times 16 is 16. Then subtract. 26 minus 16 is 10. As you can see, the quotient is 161. And obviously, it's not a hex number. So let's convert 161 into hex number. 16 divided by 16 is 1. Then 1 times 16 is 16. Bring down 1. 1 divided by 16 is 0. Then 0 times 16 is 0. Then subtract. 1 minus 0 is 1. The quotient, which is 10, is A in hexadecimal. So now we can stop dividing. Remember that you can stop dividing if the quotient is less than or equal to 15, which is F in hexadecimal. The first remainder that we get is our first hex number, and the second remainder is our second hex number, and our last hex number must be the last quotient. So 1AF goes into B36 6 times. Then 6 times 1AF is A1A. Now let's subtract. 6 minus A cannot be, so let's borrow from 3, and 3 becomes 2, borrow 16. 16 plus 6 is 22, minus A is C. Next column, 2 minus 1 is 1. Then B minus A is 1. Bring down D. 11CD is our second dividend. Let's convert it into decimal by multiplying each number by 16. B times 16 to the power of 0 is 13. Then C times 16 to the power of 1 is 192. Then 1 times 16 to the power of 2 is 256. Then 1 times 16 to the power of 3 is 4096. Let's add the results to get our decimal equivalent number, which is 4557. The next step is to find out how many times 431 goes into our second dividend, which is 4557. Now let's divide 4557 on the decimal value of our hex divisor. So 4557 divided by 431 is 10. Then 10 times 431 is 4310. Because 4310 is in decimal form, let's convert it into hexadecimal. To do that, just divide it by 16. 43 divided by 16 is 2. Then 2 times 16 is 32. Subtract 43 minus 32 is 11. Bring down 1. 111 divided by 16 is 6. Then 6 times 16 is 96. Then subtract 111 minus 96 is 15. Bring down 0. 150 divided by 16 is 9. Then 9 times 16 is 144. Subtract 150 minus 144 is 6. As you can see, the quotient is 269, and obviously it's not a hex number. So let's convert 269 into hex number. 26 divided by 16 is 1, then 1 times 16 is 16, then subtract 26 minus 16 is 10, bring down 9. 109 divided by 16 is 6, then 6 times 16 is 96. Subtract 109 minus 96 is 13. As you can see, the quotient is 16, and obviously it's not a hex number, so let's convert 16 into hex number. 16 divided by 16 is 1, then 1 times 16 is 16. Subtract 16 minus 16 is 0. The quotient, which is 1, is a hex number, so now we can stop dividing. Remember that you can stop dividing if the quotient is less than or equal to 15. The first remainder that we get is our first hex number, and the second remainder is our second hex number, and our third remainder is our third hex number, and the last quotient is our last hex number. So 1AF goes into 11CD 10 times, then 10 times 1AF is 10D6, then subtract D minus 6 is 7, the next column C minus D cannot be, so let's borrow from 1, and 1 becomes 0, borrow 16. 16 plus C is 28, minus D is F, then 1 minus 1 is 0. Bring down E. F7E is our third dividend. Let's convert it into decimal by multiplying each number by 16. E times 16 to the power of 0 is 14, then 7 times 16 to the power of 1 is 112. Then F times 16 to the power of 2 is 3840. Let's add the results to get our decimal equivalent number, which is 3966. Now, let's find out how many times 431 goes into our third dividend, which is 3966. Let's divide 3966 on the decimal value of our hex divisor. So 3966 divided by 431 is 9. Then 9 times 431 is 3879. Because 3879 is in decimal form, let's convert it into hexadecimal. To do that, just divide it by 16. 38 divided by 16 is 2. Then 2 times 16 is 32, subtract 38 minus 32 is 6, bring down 7. 67 divided by 16 is 4, then 4 times 16 is 64. Subtract 67 minus 64 is 3, bring down 9. 39 divided by 16 is 2, then 2 times 16 is 32. Subtract 39 minus 32 is 7. As you can see, the quotient is 242. And obviously, it's not a hex number, so let's convert 242 into hex number. 24 divided by 16 is 1, then 1 times 16 is 16. 24 minus 16 is 8, bring down 2. 82 divided by 16 is 5, then 5 times 16 is 80. Subtract 82 minus 80 is 2. The quotient, which is 15, is F in hexadecimal, so now we can stop dividing, because always remember that you can stop dividing if the quotient is less than or equal to 15, which is F in hexadecimal. So again, the first remainder that we get is our first hex number, and the second remainder is our second hex number, and our last quotient is our last hex number. So 1AF goes into F7E 9 times. Then 9 times 1AF is F27. Now let's subtract E minus 7 is 7, then 7 minus 2 is 5, then F minus F is 0. 57 is our remainder. So our final answer is 6A9, remainder 57. If you'd like to confirm your answer, just convert the divisor, dividend, quotient, and remainder into decimal. After getting the decimal equivalent, let's do the same process just like what we did in our hexadecimal division. After dividing, let's do the checking by multiplying the quotient and divisor. 1,705 times 431 is 734,855. And of course, don't forget to add the remainder, and the result is 734,942. As you can see, the result is similar to our dividend, so that means our answer is correct. Now, you can try to solve this problem. You can leave your answer in the comment section below.